AI will not replace you as a designer. However, a designer who's using AI will replace you. There's so much talk about ChatGPT, OpenAI, DALL-E, and all sorts of AI-assisted tools nowadays. So I was curious and tested ChatGPT if it's really that good. So in this video, I am going to show you how we designers can use ChatGPT. So how can ChatGPT help designers? Let's ask ChatGPT itself. You know, it seems I wasn't specific enough with my questions, so let's ask ChatGPT again, now focusing on UX designers. Well, according to ChatGPT, it can help assist user experience designers with the followings: generating text for use in UX design projects, for example, website copy, generating a list of ideas and suggestions for the onboarding flow, generating ideas for user flows and wireframes, that could be interesting, and it can help generate ideas for UX design concepts, and it can help provide inspiration for UX work. Okay, let's see if this is actually true. So we're going to test all of these scenarios. Let's start with generating text in UX design projects. I have a prompt here, so I put write UX copy for a new task management app's landing page. And this is what ChatGPT came up with. You know, this is a pretty good start. However, it might be a little bit too long for a landing page. So I asked ChatGPT to make it shorter, and here's what it said. Now this is much better, simpler, and even snappier. So you can keep asking ChatGPT to refine and refine the output until you're happy with the result. Next one, generating a list of ideas and suggestions for an onboarding flow. Our prompt is design the onboarding flow for a new task management app. So this is the output. We got 7 items. And guess what? ChatGPT is a conversational AI. So unlike a Google search, you don't need to enter the prompt again. You just follow up on the previous prompt and ChatGPT magically knows what you meant. So I asked ChatGPT to add a few more items to the list, and it did exactly that. Now, if you look at this, is it perfect? No, it's not perfect. However, it makes you think, and ChatGPT created this list just in a few seconds. So in a very short amount of time, you will have 10 plus items regarding onboarding for a new task management app. Now let's see if it can create wireframes. So I asked ChatGPT to create 4 screens or 4 wireframes on bullet point number 13. And this is the output that we got. Well, this is a hit and miss for sure. First of all, ChatGPT is a chat AI, so it doesn't draw any wireframes for you. And the output is, well, flawed. Super flawed. So you don't need to be a seasoned designer to spot mistakes here. It is kind of a fail because it didn't really focus on bullet point 13. So I would say for wireframing, that's not really great. Next, I asked ChatGPT to generate user flow ideas for an e-commerce application. Now, this is the output, so we got 6 items here, and I should say this is pretty good. This is a pretty good starting flow if you don't know how to start a project. However, if you're an experienced designer and if you've done e-commerce or commerce project before, you would be able to write a list very similar to this very easily. Okay, next one, inspiration for UX work, kind of a desk research. I asked ChatGPT to give me a 5 most popular e-commerce websites with links. If you want to have links, you need to tell ChatGPT that you want the links. So we got 5 outputs, that's pretty good. And now I wanted to see if ChatGPT can do some kind of competitor analysis. So I asked, list 5 competitors of Amazon. So that's our output. And you know, you could have arrived at the same result by doing a simple Google search, but this is a good starting point and you saved a few minutes. Okay, now what about design research? So I asked to write me an introduction to a usability test, imitating Steve Krug. This is our output. And I need to say, this is a good starting point that you would be able to copy paste and make it your own by adding all of the little details you want to include. I am not 100% sure how much ChatGPT could imitate Steve Crook though, but you can try to test it with other, maybe a more well-known figure, like a politician. Okay, next we have writing a usability test script. Let's see if ChatGPT can do that. I asked it to write me a usability testing script for a pet sitter iOS application. I also told ChatGPT that I wanted to find out what makes users use a pet sitter. And this is the output that we got. This is a pretty long list, but you might think that this is okay, but the output is actually different from what I had in mind. This output looks more like a usability testing task list that you can ask from users. So it seems my prompt wasn't clear enough. So let's give it another go. So now I say, I would like to interview pet owners. I would like to find out what makes them use a pet sitter and write me 15 interview questions I can ask pet owners. Now, this output is much closer to what I imagined initially. The questions are okay. However, I was expecting ChatGPT to display more questions answering the prompt. I would have liked to see more questions similar to number two, questions that could really dive deep into pet owners' motivation to get a pet sitter. Okay, moving on. I asked ChatGPT to write me a research plan for a UX discovery research of the pet sitter market. Again, the output is a good start. For better results, I would recommend predetermining the research goals and objectives and the target audience when you ask a question like that from ChatGPT. Moving on to summarizing big block of text. This is the area where ChatGPT shines. You can drop actually anything here, any big block of text, interview notes, research notes, and it will summarize it for you. So I tried it with an article that I wrote recently. So I copy-pasted the text. And I must say, the summary is accurate. Well done, AI. Yay! Next one. Generating design sprint workshop outline. Here's our prompt, and this is our output. Short, but it covers everything, like at a high level. And as ChatGPT says, the output is a generic outline. So from here, you can ask ChatGPT to elaborate on each day by adding more meat to them. As someone who had run design sprint multiple times in the past, I would be better off writing the details myself, actually, instead of asking ChatGPT. However, this is a great outline to get started if you are entirely new to Google design sprints. But you know, to successfully run a design sprint, you need to do some background reading on the topic. So now I wanted to see if ChatGPT can help us help designers get a new job. How about writing a cover letter? I inserted the link to the job ad. And this is our output. Well, you know what? No wonder why my previous video on YouTube tanked. Guys, there is no excuse for not writing cover letters anymore. It takes a minute. You massage it for another 5 minutes so that it's actually true, and you are done. Wow. Now this is really good. I tested if ChatGPT can suggest design tasks to practice. So I asked for 10 UX design prompts so then I can practice design challenges and add them to my design portfolio. And ChatGPT nailed this task. So this is really good. If you want to practice design, then ChatGPT can give you a prompt and you can spend 15-30 minutes every single day and just practice designing a concept for each of these prompts. Okay, now let's see if it can do logo design. So I asked ChatGPT to design a logo for a beauty therapist. And this is the output. And this is very similar to the wireframing question, right? Because ChatGPT cannot draw yet. So it cannot design a logo for you. However, it describes what a specific logo should look like. It even offers font suggestions to complete the overall brand identity. Soon we can say goodbye to Fiverr, I think. Okay, now what's next for ChatGPT? You know, ChatGPT is a conversational AI. It's really good at writing. It's really good at coming up with written concepts. It can also completely replace Google search. You know, ChatGPT is not going to make writers great writers, as DALL-E doesn't make an artist a great artist overnight. Even though there are Grammarly and Virtune and Quillbot and many other AI writing tools, they still haven't replaced human editors. There's Canva and there's Adobe Express and there are still graphic designers. So I believe there will be always market for human-made products. It's like how you pay premium for a hand knit cardigan, right? So for us designers, I predict that there will be a tool soon enough where we enter a prompt like design a login flow happy path for a pet sitter iOS application, and maybe not ChatGPT, but maybe like a UX AI tool will do exactly that. You know, ChatGPT is something I never knew I needed. Someone who writes a lot, who summarizes a lot of like big block of text when I do research, this will be super useful for me. But let's always remember ChatGPT's constraint when we use it to assist our work. So you should never take the output at face value. Take it as a starting point and develop it further and apply critical thinking to it, because ChatGPT still creates incorrect answers. But I am really excited to see where it goes and what the other AI tools might come to the market. So let's embrace ChatGPT and all of the other AI tools. If you haven't tried ChatGPT yet, then go ahead and let me know if you find another use case that we can use ChatGPT for. I would love to hear about your discovery. I hope you enjoyed this video and I see you next time. Bye!